So let's take a look at the first day of the Elite 11 quarterback competition out there in Los Angeles, where the top 20 high school quarterbacks are now competing. And first and foremost, as expected, Dylan Raiola looked like the number one quarterback in the nation, as he just looks a little more polished and a few steps ahead of everyone else, which proves why he's probably the number one quarterback in the nation. All it does to me is wonder what could have been if he would have committed to the Huskers. Could Dylan have been the difference in pulling Nebraska out of this 20-year funk they've been in and brought them back to the Tom Osborne days? Who knows? I mean, his statue could have been sitting right there next to Tom Osborne's leading into the stadium there in Lincoln. We could all just wonder, but to me, he definitely could have made a difference in bringing the Cornhuskers back to where they once were. It just proves that no matter who you are or where your dad played his college ball at, if you don't win, you're not going to get the top recruits in the nation. But in today's competition, Dylan, 6'3", 220 pounds, he just made things look easy on day one. I mean, from all the throws, from all the competition throws, from the routes in the air to stationary throws, almost everything he did with ease. He just makes throws so effortlessly. And to me, he's just a step above everyone else. Probably a decent gap between him and number two. He showed to me that Dylan Raiola could step into any Power 5 program right now and be the number one quarterback on that team. And I mean any Power 5 program, and that's including the Bulldogs, where he's headed. So I expect Dylan Raiola to be the Bulldogs' number one QB come 2024 opening game. But Dylan wasn't the only quarterback out there that actually looked pretty good. Another one that looked really good and was really impressive was Florida State commit Luke Kromenhoek. He showed a very live arm and a better passer than most sites think. He's more polished than I thought. I think he's even more polished than experts even think. To me, he looked and probably to me is the second or third best quarterback in the nation, right behind Dylan Raiola, and he's definitely further along in his development than most anyone thinks. So I would keep an eye on this young man throughout this competition this weekend and throughout his career. Now let's take a look at the Big Ten commits. The first and foremost is Michigan commit Jadyn just over 6 foot, 202 pounds, and is considered to be the second best quarterback by most recruiting sites in the nation. And it's hard to argue with that, but to me, I would still put Kromenhoek at this point above him. But you definitely can't go wrong if Davis is your guy, as he looked very promising out there and showed why he's one of the top quarterbacks in the nation. Another Big Ten commit that looked really promising today was N.I.L, the Ohio State commit, and he's the only lefty out of the group. Noland stands good 6'3", 6'4", a hair under 200 pounds. Looked like he's grown some here lately. And he's considered considered the seventh-ranked quarterback in the nation. And one thing I noticed about Noland is his quick releases on his throws, as he doesn't waste time getting rid of the ball. And he showed this throughout the day in all the throwing competitions at every level, which is very promising for the Buckeyes. Now, I wouldn't be a true Husker fan if I didn't bring up Daniel Kaelin, the Husker commit, the 6'3", 200-pound commit, and again, one of the smartest football IQs around and that I've ever seen. And he showed today, on day one, that he belongs with this group. I think he did have a few nerves kick in at the beginning of the day, and it might have been just being around Dylan and the rest of the guys, mainly considering he was kind of second to Dylan most of the year. But it took him a little bit to get going, but once he did, he showed the Huskers and the rest of the world what they could expect out of him, and showed the Huskers should be excited to have this young man. Now, the recruiting sites have Kaelin around the 25th rank in the nation, and I feel this is kind of low, and I feel by the end of this weekend, he's probably going to impress some of them to the point he's probably going to get a higher ranking. As he showed, he should be higher than 25th. And just him being invited to the Elite 11 should be a sign he's higher than 25th, as the Elite 11 tries to grab what they think is the top 20 quarterbacks in the nation. Not many are talking about Daniel Kaelin outside of Nebraska, of course, but you have to remember, this kid didn't become a starter until his junior year. And yes, he does have a few mechanical things to improve on, but they're all coachable things, and his development outlook is high, and he has a lot of attributes that you just can't teach, especially when it comes to his throws, as the ball just pops off his hands. And this is from a young man that's just beginning in his development, and I feel has one of the highest developmental upsides of any quarterback there is. And the good thing is that he has one of the better developers in college football in Matt Rhule. So I expect to see extreme improvement from this young man before he departs Lincoln in his career. So the Huskers should consider themselves lucky to even have this young man, especially how late in the year they snatched him up. But let's keep an eye on him and see how he does the next couple days during this Elite 11 competition, and see how well he does as he gets a little more comfortable being around these young men. Now, if you don't mind, please subscribe and click the like button, as I'd really would appreciate that. And if you would like to show your support by leaving a small $1 or $2 tip, you can do so by using the Super Thanks button right below the video, as we're grateful for all the support we receive. Again, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Go Big Red!